Okay, my desk is a mess and I apologize, but I had a bit of an issue this week where this is my regular machine. It's a T430. And for the past few weeks, I know it's been giving me some issues. One, it wasn't charging the battery. And two, sometimes whenever I plug the USB port in, it wasn't recognizing, or anything into the USB ports, it wasn't recognizing it. And the mouse would be all over the place jumping. So that makes me start to think that it's getting a motherboard issue, which is possible. I mean, it's a 4 or 5 year old machine. It's an i5 third gen. I really like it. It's a great little machine, but it's time for me to get rid of it. Now, I have so much crap on the hard drive that I didn't really want to pull everything off and back it up and move it all over because that is just a nightmare. So I went and I bought another T430, pretty much with the exact same specs, just so I could make the swap and just put my hard drive in here and reactivate Windows. So I buy this off this guy off the Facebook Messenger app, and let me see if I can show you what happened here. Did I take the hard drive out of my machine? So when you take out a Lenovo ThinkPad laptop or a hard drive, this is how they come out. They have this little tab here. I know the lighting's bad, I apologize. And then you pull it out. And that's it. It comes out with a caddy and this tab, and these things pop on the side. And these are what you call a 7mm thin drive. The drive he had in there was this 1 terabyte 9mm thick hard drive jammed in there, which is thicker than the caddy, and there wasn't even a caddy installed. It was just jammed in there, and I had a hell of a time pulling that out. You can see I'd use these needle nose pliers here. I'm trying to pull on it like this to pull it out, so who knows what kind of damage I've done to the drive, but I don't need the hard drive anyway. That's irrelevant to me. So I'm just going to put my old hard drive in there, which I've already done this, it works fine, but what happened is my old T430 has 16 gigs of RAM, this only has 8. So I'm going to pull the memory, well I've already pulled the memory out, of my old T430, and I'm going to put it in here. And I just wanted to go through the steps and see if you were interested in watching that with me. This is the 8 gig memory here. So what happens on this when you pull it out here? I should have said this at the beginning. Let me put this at the beginning. No power, no battery. Take the hard drive out. Take everything out in case there's any kind of static discharge that you do not want to be surprised with. There's 8 gigs here under the slot, and then there's 8 gigs under the keyboard that we have to get to. So to do that, we have to pull this off. Now my old T430, I'm going to use just strictly as a parts machine. I might sell it, but I'm going to cannibalize it first. Okay, so this is a 4 gig stick of RAM. So you can see there's 2 slots there. You kind of push them forward, and then it pops out like that. Okay, so that 4 gig is out. Now, to get the keyboard out, you have to take out this screw up here, this one, and this one. Now they are both going to be really long screws like that. And then you're going to pull the keyboard out. And once you do that, you have to be really gentle with it. Sometimes it might give you a bit of a battle, like this one will. Okay, there's that. And like I said, this one. And you can usually see a little picture of a keyboard beside it. I don't know if the light will show it or not, but right there, is a little plastic stamped keyboard. So that's that, that's that. Keep this one in, I think. Okay, so that should be that, that should be that. All right. Flipping the keyboard over now for the fun part. So we have to push it forward slightly, and then we have to lift it carefully. So I'm going to use this flat butter knife just to kind of nudge it forward carefully. You don't want to scratch the plastic or anything. See, it kind of pops up like that. Very careful, because underneath there is a ribbon, and it's not hard to put back in, but it could be a pain in the ass sometimes. So just lift it up, pull it out. I twist it ever so slightly. You can see the ribbon here. And there's a stick of RAM. See it? Right there. Okay, so we're popping this one out. Okay. Now I'm putting the 8 gig in. And it only goes one way. You see where the notch is on here? See how it's like short, long? The notch is right there. So that notch, they just line up over here. Okay, now you just reverse this, slide it up, push it in, make sure it's in there. Then you kind of pull it back towards you. It's a little popped up there, I gotta push it down. Okay, so that's in. Now I'm going to say this, I should have said this at the beginning. Let me put this at the beginning. No power, no battery. Take the hard drive out, take everything out in case there's any kind of static discharge that you do not want to be surprised with. Okay, so now we're going to put the 8 gig in here. Put our long screws back in. Now let me show you the coolest thing about the T430s that I really like about them. This is the standard DVD drive, CD reader, CD whatever it is, DVD drive, CD burner that it comes with. Just a typical little drive. Now on eBay for about $10, you can buy this. It's a caddy for a hard drive. So what I did is I stuck in a 1 terabyte drive, and now instead of having a CD drive, which I never use anyway, who uses these things, I now have a second hard drive that goes inside there. So now my storage has changed from, well, it came with a 1 terabyte 5400 RPM drive, which is absolutely slow. I put in a 480 gig solid state drive. And now I also have a 1 terabyte drive on the side. So I have 1.5 terabytes of storage on this machine. Okay, let's put this all back together. Your caddy back together. Put our optical drive back in. Now, this is from a Slim, because I used to have a T430S, so that's why there was just a little bit of a gap there. You can see it right there, but it's not really that noticeable. Okay, let's power this thing on and see if the BIOS and everything. Okay, 16 gigs of RAM, 15.7 usable. And the keyboard works, and the mouse works, and everything works. And there's my 512 gig SSD. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for joining me on this journey. I hope that we can talk again. I much appreciate your patience with me. And I do apologize for not making as many videos lately. I've just been busy. I do have another YouTube channel, though, in case you're ever feeling the need to go by it and check it out. It's where I play this game, HQ Trivia, all the time. So go on there, sign up. You sign up, I get a free life. Don't use my name, though, because I, as you can see, I've got lots of free lives. Use my kid's name, which is Lim Lom Lam. Anyway, I digress. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to talk to you again. Have a good weekend. It's Easter.